Welcome back to Let's Code. I'm Chris Biscardi, and today we are talking about ignoring files in your Rust CLI apps. Now, it's a pretty common use case when building infrastructure tooling to want to be able to ignore, say, the same files as a .gitignore or a .npmignore or a .whateverignore, .dockerignore, .whatever. On the right here, I have an extremely small example of what a gitignore looks like if you're not familiar with one. It's basically a list of files and directories and things like that, that you would like ignored for the purposes of whatever the tool is doing. Here I've generated a very simple new cargo Rust application. So normally I would set up an example and say, hey, look, we're gonna go walk the directory and find a bunch of files, and look, we don't see some of these, right? Or rather, we do see too many files. But it turns out that the ignore crate actually builds on top of the walkdir crate. So if you were going to traverse a directory and find a bunch of files, walkdir is probably where I would have pointed you anyway. Here you can see that iterating over a directory is as easy as doing for entry in walkdir new at some place, print the path. So using the walk crate on the right, we can see that we are using this walk struct. We're using the new function to look at all of the directories that are in dot slash. We've matched on the results. It's either going to be an error or it's going to be the entry so that we can get the path. We print the path, and that gives us the output on the left-hand side here. We've got a cargo toml, a cargo lock, a source, and a main.rs. Now, if I ls, we can see that there is a target directory here, and that's because when we created this project using cargo new, it automatically created a gitignore for us that removed target. So if we do actually go into the gitignore and we get rid of that, and we run, we can see all of the files from the target directory pop through. And this is all of the intermediary Rust compilation objects and things like that. So they're not really things we want to see, right? And we can see that if we put target back, then all of that is gone. So this is a super easy way if you're trying to traverse a directory, such as having built a project for having built a CLI for a specific project or something like that, something that will run in the root, something that will traverse some huge directory of files. And you want the user to be able to define, you know, what files get searched or something like that. This is a great way to do it. Now, there is also a builder API here. So for result in walk builder, which is an iterator, we're going to do new at the current directory. We're going to specify whether to show hidden files or not, and then we're going to build that. And by building that, we get this iterator that we can use, and we can print out the results. In this case, we aren't doing the fancy entry.path or the match, so we get the entire dir entry output. Now, this is, of course, really interesting and useful, and it's something that I really enjoy having. It makes it really easy to discover, or rather not discover, files that you don't want around that are commonly desired by users to not show up in the CLI. And the thing that I find the most interesting, actually, is that this is one of the ripgrep crates. So ripgrep, if you're not familiar, is a Rust CLI tool for recursively searching directories. It's a replacement for grep or ack or whatever you happen to be using, the silver searcher, ag. So for example, I could do ripgrep walk, and it would find, you know, the walk builder that we just had in the source folder. Of course, if you're familiar with grep, you know that we have to then, you know, specify the file that we're looking for. It doesn't work quite as well. The line numbers aren't there, things like that. So I actually really like ripgrep, which is one of the reasons that I am so excited about this being a ripgrep crate. So we can take a dive in here and we can look at the dependencies that it relies on. There are a decent amount of them, some that you might, you know, not expect, like crossbeam utils. But down at the bottom here, you can see walkdir, which is exactly where I would have sent you originally. And you can do absolutely bonkers stuff like simd accelerate the way that you ignore files in this search. Some of the examples in the repo here show how to do things like use a number of threads to build a recursive directory searcher that ignores these files for you in parallel, which is quite a use case if that's your use case. But I just wanted to point out that the ignore crate isn't just a simple wrapper over walkdir. It enables you to do quite a bit using the underlying walkdir APIs. And honestly, if it's good enough for ripgrep, it's going to be good enough for any CLI that I write. So that's the ignore crate. It's a really useful crate if you have this specific problem. It is not something that, you know, you would use in every project that you're ever going to have, but it is quite nice to know about. So I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you learned something new today, and I'll catch you in the next video.